With the radio invention in 1920 and Congress enacting the Radio Act in 1927, yet another invention was to be demonstrated at the New York World's Fair in 1939. The television, invented by no other than Philo T. Farnsworth. And with that, starting a whole new generation.
Broadcasting, a broad medium all over the world today that lists TV and radio on the top. Ever since the beginning of TV and radio, it has influenced everyone's lives in some way. Hello and welcome to our program about what it takes to make it in broadcasting. We will show you some of the on-the-job and overview situations you will encounter in television. This program is designed for anyone that's ever been curious about the magical world of television. We'll take a look behind the scenes of enthusiastic students applying their skills, creativity, to possible future careers. Now let's take a look behind the scenes.
Los Angeles being one of the most media-concentrated cities in the United States, its broad spectrum of multimedia services and the motion picture studios will only widen and progress further in the years to come. In this city, one does not have to drive far to get there. At Los Angeles City Schools, children as young as elementary school age get exposed to the exciting world of television broadcasting, where they explore their own interests and develop basic skills and techniques in production.
Thank you, Tracy, for that report.
Most colleges and universities around the nation have state-of-the-art television production facilities and studios where individuals explore the medium to a further extent, where mistakes can be made and learned from.
It all started back about a year ago. We got a color TV with remote control.
Mass communication is the key to learn about the world, be it in the news or in entertainment. Computers play a big role as well, and is making the medium even more powerful.
Now day after day, she's in a regular place.
Chris, the LAPD. See ya. Nice talking to ya.
McLaw?
Stand up and be counted. Throw your hat in the ring.
Don't stop.
Make the pendulum swing.
No, don't stop it.
Maybe just put the right foot.
So if you're looking for a career in broadcasting, be it in radio, television, cable, acting, announcing, camera techniques, pre-post production, then go ahead and contact your local college now.
Professor of Broadcasting at Los Angeles Valley College. I came here after 23 years on the air in New York and Los Angeles. I was introduced to broadcasting in one of the few ways it was possible to get in during those days. I started with Armed Forces Radio Service while serving in the Army and broadcast for a couple of years in Vienna, Austria, where I was assigned. Those who work in television often think of it as being a visual medium which involves speech, which of course it does, but the speech has to be written. Also, television or any other of the broadcasting media is primarily storytelling, and you have to know how to tell a story. And the best way to learn how to tell a story is to read the experts. So a lot of reading, literature courses, general education as background for a broadcasting career. The technical courses are important, but they're important in that you learn how to use the instruments, that is the cameras and mixers and the various electronic gadgetry that goes into broadcasting. But you use it to tell a story. And if you learn the process of telling the story as opposed to how to work each individual piece of equipment, you'll be learning something valuable. If you're going to work on camera, you have to develop a personality, an ability to smile when you don't feel like smiling, and of course an ability to communicate one-on-one with that individual in the audience who is watching your performance. You need to have a broad background as possible, know about a lot of things, and I think the one essential personal quality would probably be curiosity. You have to want to know about things in order to retain that information. So if you are curious and enthusiastic about things, that enthusiasm will pass on and the knowledge will pass on to the audience. My final piece of advice to anyone who would work in broadcasting, whether they be in the writing end, directing end, performing in front of the camera, or the creative aspect of it in any way, is to recognize that it is a communication medium and that we have not left behind the older ways of communication because we're using a new one in the electronic medium. One must still know how to tell a story, one must still be able to write, one must still be able to communicate succinctly with each other as well as with the audience. So accept every opportunity you have to put things in writing. Accept every opportunity you have to read something and translate it to someone else. In other words, practice communication.
Answered some of your questions. Working in television requires skill and most of all knowledge. If you want to further your mind in this field, then you're on your way to have your chance in the industry. Situations you will encounter in television. How was that? Skills and creativity to possible future skills. Career! Stealing shoes, that was funny, what a man. Touching. Now we're rolling, and here we go. A broad medium all over the world today, that this TV and radio on the top ever since. No, see, ever since the beginning. Okay?